although they were the top 10 of the country coming into NSRCL for incubation with support, seed support of 20 lakh rupees, they were still hesitant. The parents were like, why are you going to take up entrepreneurship when your students or your when your friends are taking up 10 lakh packages across the country? And we need that right now. But the only thing that our mentors and myself used to tell them is that if you take that up as a job and you learn something in 10 years, you take up entrepreneurship, you learn everything in 1 year. So the best effort is to take that plunge, learn by failing. Otherwise, entrepreneurship is nothing. If you are afraid to fail, you should never even think about entrepreneurship. The best answer to your question is, why do I fail? You have to pick yourself up, come back, and work on it. You should never give up. That should be the attitude. And that attitude is always required to be inscribed in our students rather than anyone else. And that's why I feel that this is very important for the students, for the development of the economy, and for the development of themselves. I just came back from an engineering college today before I came to BIA, and I was telling them the same thing as well. The students are very important for us in this program, and I would really recommend. If you're done with the studies, though, you should be done with either your master's or bachelor's, and make sure that this is not hindering your studies process. But once you graduate, I think this is something that you should test out. That's what I believe.
Yeah, just to add to what Bharat said, I think there is this logistical constraint that you should complete the course before you start the incubation. Apart from that, I don't see any constraint in a student applying there. The other part is, I think the incubation period, there is a fixed stipend. So it is not like you get out of it and you're not doing, even when you are experimenting during the 1 year, there is some financial support. So if I were a student, given there is going to be a financial support for me to explore, I think that is the right age to explore. And not fail, I would say, I think you will probably succeed. So don't worry, I think student is the best time to to start. And there is a financial support. It's not like 1 year I'm going to sit without any money. Okay, so that's all I needed.
And after
completing
the degree,
it's not
good for that.
At least the degree must be... I think it is not the problem of people who are getting intimidated, it is a problem of IIM that people are getting intimidated by the IIM. So we have to work towards being relevant in society for a large number of people. And as I told, these are steps we are taking to become more relevant and less intimidating. That is how I see it. It's not your problem that you are getting intimidated by IIM's name, it's IIM's problem. And that is where putting it in racial language is one such effort. I think we are the ones who have to be thinking about this much more and have to make us less intimidating and more approachable. And these are efforts that we are putting in to get that done. Okay, so you don't have to think about why is it. You can maybe blame us for being somebody who are looked as intimidating, and we are trying to get it away, get that tag away slowly, hopefully steadily.
I have a question. I am running my own business from last 2 years or 3 years, but I have another different idea, entirely different idea. Then if I got selected for the incubation, then I will have to leave everything that I'm doing right now and then put my entire effort on for that 1 year mini project, or how one could go about it?
If you can manage both,
okay.
If you run a business for 2 to 3 years, you would have been in a position where you're making enough revenue already. And you're in a position where you're taking decisions and there's an operations team which can take care of everything. Right? And now all of a sudden you want to become a serial entrepreneur by identifying another opportunity. Please go ahead. You have to apply to this program, work on that product, on this new one. And I think as long as you're in entrepreneurship, you know, you will come up with ideas where you can balance on what are the strengths and the weaknesses and what are the mistakes you made in the first business that can be rectified and implemented. So it's always there. As long as you're on the entrepreneur stage, please come in and run with us. That's all I can say.
Sir, I'm a psychological and career counselor. Can this be of any help?
If you are willing to start a venture where you would like to, probably, I would just give you examples of creating platforms for psychological doctors in and across country where it's easy for them to find the right, I'm just giving you examples. So you have to think about an idea. When you go through this MOOC, all you will come through is look at the idea generation techniques in your perspective. Everybody has their own potential. Everybody has their own areas of interest. So take up your perspective and bring in your idea into the idea generation room and you just take it forward from there. You have to implement based on what your skill sets and interests are. That should work. So it does not stop. See, like I said, you should not think about the background you're coming from. You should think about where you want to go. If you're willing to start. Just do it. See, that's the first philosophy that we have for Do Your Venture, which is our MOOC course. The first week is the Do Your Venture. Do philosophy that we introduced you to. Don't think this. That's what this is.
And if I'm unable to work this year, but I want to take this 4-5 week course,
yes.
And after that I'm unable to give so much time.
Yes.
And if I want to repeat it again next
year,
then
This is free knowledge. We are giving you free knowledge. Please feel free to access our MOOC. Even if you know for sure that you're not taking up incubation or you're not taking up the boot camp or you don't want to submit a lead canvas, not an issue.
Can you explain the word MOOC a little more clearly?
Yeah.
The word MOOC is very
exciting. Okay. It's just a simple word. It is massive open online course. So it's termed by edX and Harvard and MIT who started this. Basically, a MOOC is a virtual classroom. The professors at IMB or professors at IM, any premier institution will have limited access when it comes to talking to you guys. So I'll tell you the MOOC version of this conversation that we are having. I got to know that BIA also does Facebook Live, recording it and go live. That is the MOOC version of this conversation. That is all. So when you're able to access technology and deliver it to the larger audience, where they can remotely access you just with the internet is
more. Yeah, but the timing? The timing is going to be flexible, right? We can, at our own convenience, go on, it will be a fixed time that the...
Every week there will be new content that will be released.
Right. And you can access...
You can access throughout,
anytime.
There will be deadlines for you to submit your assignment, for example. So Monday the course releases. So everything is on the video. Next Sunday at around 10 p.m., I'm just giving you hypothetically, will be the deadline for all that activity, all that week. You just go through the video for like half an hour on Wednesday, half an hour on Friday, 2 hours on the weekend because you're free. But Sunday you have to submit it. That's it.
Per week, one assignment is there?
Not really, it was. And based on the different weightages of the marketers. I mean, the first week it would just be a survey which will count to 5% of the overall 100% mark. The second week would be a knowledge check which would be 10% of the overall. Week 4 is the most crucial. Lean Canvas, when you are introduced to this concept of Lean Canvas, because the whole thought of putting your idea on the paper, right, that is what counts for us 60 marks, 60% of the mark. And for you to successfully complete this course or pass this course, you should have completed with 60% percentage. So lean canvas is that one big chunk which will give you that 60%, and everything else will be knowledge checks, surveys, and probably kind of like quizzes. And the lean canvas is not just once you just submit the final lean canvas. Over a period of time, you start building it. As soon as we introduce you to lean canvas in week 3, you'll still go validate with the customer, probably meet, talk to your friends amongst your friends, and then you come up with a newer version. Maybe you thought the problem statement should have ABC, and your friend says, no, BC is not, there's no point in having BC here. You usually focus on A. You maybe have to rethink. And when you talk to the customer, maybe they give you a different perspective. So it's a lot of, you know, process of putting your thoughts and canceling it off and probably rehydration. So version 1, version 2, version 3, version 4. We also will be tracking how we will evolve over that.
Yeah, so it is not a one-shoe-fits-all.
It's not a one-shoe-fits-all.
It's individualistic. I mean, in the sense, it's not a mass club, but it's individually tailor-made for each individual partner.
So this year, what we also have is a startup wing as a platform developed by a startup in California. So what this does is probably create a profile for you. You know, it's like this. You go to startup wing, you put your idea there. We'll assign some mentors there, we'll assign some panel of judges there. You just keep iterating your ideas there. You submit a new canvas probably the next week, and we'll be able to track all that changes that we have. So from week 3 to week 6, we'll be tracking on what you're developing.
Facebook can take this idea from you.
Facebook is already there, but I think Startup India has come from Facebook. I think startup build has come from Facebook as well. As a wall creation, it's like having a platform where all your ideas are right there. It's defining your business idea. Facebook, like it defines your profile, a personal profile, this would be a startup profile. That's it. Yeah.
If I have a partner with me for my business, so how go about, like,
are we looking at a woman or a
no, my partner is my
sister. Okay. So I would suggest both of you take MOOC, both of you work on it differently, and both of you submit your lean canvases. And when it comes to the boot camp, one of you will be selected, maybe. And once you start incubation, you will have a co-founder which can be a sister. So you will have an office space for at least 2 people at IIM Nagpur campus. So both you and your co-founder, regardless of if it's a male or female, because we saw from our women, right? A lot of them are married to their husband. And this gave them an opportunity to get their husbands on board. No, they were working as software professionals, but since they believed in their wife's idea, they would want to quit, and they probably wanted to come back and support them. So, Deepika Anup and Subrata Kulkarni, right? Both of them are supported by their husbands. And Anushka Shetty is actually supported by her cousin, who is also the tech guy. So every company has 2 different expertise, right? So one of them has to look at the business, one of them has to look at the product and service. So there should be a complementary skill set. And you're free to choose your partner.
During the incubation period of this 1 year, how much time actually spent at the institute? Or is it online?
No, the incubation is completely offline, and you have to be there most of your time. This is your office, this is your new baby. Okay, how much time would you give it to your new baby? That's it. You just have to make sure that the baby
the
grows
business
up. The business grows up and take the support from all the mentors. And we will be hosting a lot of sessions live from IMT. The ones that institutions like IIM Nagpur could not approach due to geographical constraints, we have those support in IMT, right? So those will be live streamed from IMT, and all of you can sit in the classroom and just probably have sessions like this with us. That's the end. Any other questions before we close? I think Shivaji. So I think
the funding agency is
one last DST. Question for
the funding agency is the DST for this all during this
Goldman Sachs.
Both Goldman Sachs. One last question.
As you know, there is no residency. Then what is the benefit of WSP sponsors or organizing committee?
What's the benefit for us?
No, no. For them. There is no registration fee to us now.
Yeah.
What is the benefit for DST involvement?
For DST.
Yeah, this is the Startup India initiative. So,
the only way in which the government can drive this Startup India initiative is by investing on its people, right? Who else other than its own public institution can't drive the money to anybody else? So they believe in academic experts that they have in the central government organizations like IIM, and they would want to drive that change on the platform. And like Goldman Sachs is also a part of the CSR initiative, so maybe that is why. They would want to also promote women
entrepreneurship.
Why? Can we have other questions with, along with the tea maybe? Or do we continue with two more questions, let's say? Two more questions and then we will.
Most of the slides which we are seeing of the, women entrepreneurs, women entrepreneurs, were related with, online. Things which are, most of the products are online, apps or some of are there any businesses currently of the last batch which are into manufacturing, trading or services as well?
We have some. See, that was the point I wanted to stress this time as well. See, as long as you don't adapt science to technology, there is no skill, right? So we had one woman who was doing Jyoti, who was doing a laddu, power laddu. So she combines all the natural ingredients and makes a very beautiful laddu. It's very good for diabetics because it has zero sugar. She uses dates as a bonding material or something like that. She is an amazing product maker. But she doesn't know how to sell and how to adapt technology to scale it up. So she is not looking forward to a co-founder or someone who is supporting her on that field itself. And that's probably the reason why she is not featured there. Right? So the adaption of technology and science to scale it up and create a cascading effect, that is what we are looking at. We are looking at hiring more women into the ventures itself and creating a story of spreading women entrepreneurship across the country. There were volunteering platforms where people come in and volunteer and sign up. And there are companies which support, what is Anuradha Suresh? Anuradha Suresh is, no, not the Suresh, the pregnancy thing. So she kind of, I think, supports pregnant women to the actual way of making sure that the pregnancy, is not terminated irregularly or something like that. So she has women with a 30,000 stipend that she's getting. She's had interns like 4 or 5 women in her apartment who are going across and spreading the word and making sure that it creates a cascading effect. Each one taking 6,000 rupees from it for just their expenses, right? So that is the sort of drive that we would want to look at. This is only about cascading entrepreneurship and empowering women across the country. So you are good at it, you are more than happy to support. Yeah. So we have this one last one.
Mandate
for the
program.
Yeah.
Sir, my doubt is something different. I am being funded by DST recently. I have been awarded postdoctoral fellowship from Department of Science and Technology. So, is it recommendable for me? Because I am committed to DST for the year, next year.
I think you should leave to give some other person this time. You should not do this because you already have one there. But for doing the course and thing, not for the institution part.
Yeah, that is box is for everybody.
So, is your fellowship contract also says that you cannot be a part of any other initiative?
No, for course and practice.
So the course is completely fine. If you want to take up the MOOC course, it's just an online platform where you're learning.
Only course and practice. Because
institution and why can't. Yes. Go ahead, take the course. Regardless, I've been getting questions where men cannot take courses or what? I said, go ahead, man. Who's stopping you? Vijay yourself has made that. I mean, we've given you general preference as well. Take up the course, not an issue. Just get the basics of entrepreneurship right if you're still willing. That's the beauty of MOOCs, right? So, not an issue. So, I think I will just end the session with that and give a chance for us to conclude with a vote of thanks. And I'll be there at the coffee for you to ask any more questions. Thank you very much for this.
Thank you, Bharat. Now I will not take much time because it's already late. But thank you for giving the crystal clear idea about this women startup program, and also thank you for clearing all the doubts. I hand over the podium to our secretary Rita Landiwa for thanksgiving. Thank you, ma'am. So, friends, today we all are very privileged to have with us for this program, this management program for women entrepreneurs for startups. It's a very good initiative by IIM Nagpur and IIM Bangalore under the mastermind of Goldman Sachs. I am sure that we all will take advantage of this program, and this LSR CEL help us to shape up our idea of business, and by giving expertise, mentoring us, and also by giving financial support, and will help in making a concrete enterprise from our dreams. So I thank you, Professor T. Raghunathan sir, Ms. Dipti, and Mr. Bharat for giving the detailed information of this program in a consolidated way. Thank you, sir. I would like to thank VI President Atul sir, Atul Pandey sir, VI Secretary Dr. Suhas Dhune sir, and Atit Sinha sir for their constant support and encouragement to organize these programs. I would like to thank the audience for their participating in this program, and I'm sure that you will take advantage of today's program. I thank all the executive committee members of AILAW for their constant involvement to make every program a success. I would like to thank Rode ma'am for a smooth conduction of this program. I would like to thank VIA office and VIA staff for providing this hall and all these arrangements for this to organize a smooth program. Today's program, and also I would like to thank the press people for a great coverage they are giving for the program. So friends, I am sure that all will enjoy this incubation journey if possibly selected, and fulfill all their dreams and empower yourself. All the best to all of you. Thank you.
And special thanks to the AEW of VIA. They have been responsible for making all of you come here. And very special thanks to Ms. Rote. I think she gave such generous introduction about me. I can use that in class when students are making. I can say, like, look at me, who I am. You can, Ms. Rote told me this. I'm not so big anyway. So, but anyway, thanks a lot, AEW, all the members. For being so collegial and also being enthusiastic even after 2 hours of telling something. Okay, thanks a lot. Yeah.